President Biden pledges that all adults 18 and over will be eligible for the vaccine by May 1. The rollout is already picking up. According to the CDC, nearly 97 million vaccine doses have now been administered in the U.S. I believe Mr. Biden said 100 shots in his first 100 days. He's on pace to beat that by a mile. But will we have the infrastructure to handle it when we step up beyond phase one, phase two, phase three? Michael Maron is president and CEO of Holy Name Medical Center in Teaneck, New Jersey. His site is currently vaccinating about 3,000 people a day. We'll see whether he can do better than that. Mr. Maron, welcome back. Can you up it from 3,000? If so, how high can you go?
We actually can, Tyler. So thank you. Our site is one of the most efficient in New Jersey. We're right in the top in terms of volume of vaccinating people. All we have to do is extend our hours. We could add a couple of more stations. We're currently running 18. We could extend the stations and we can extend our operating hours. We're doing easily 3,000 a day just in an 8-hour workday. So if we go to 10 or 12 hours, we can increase that capacity significantly.
Are there impediments to that, or are the impediments merely financial? And I don't mean merely, but are they financial impediments? Why not just do it?
Well, finances is a factor, but not for us. So far, this is a 100% Holy Name staffed and paid for operation. The town of Teaneck has been great to us in donating and letting us use the community health center, which is ideal for this, two large gymnasiums. So that's working well. The biggest impediment is the inconsistency of supply of vaccine. So it makes it very, very difficult to try to schedule and people when vaccine supply is erratic.
Hey, Michael.
How are people coming to you? How are they scheduling their appointments with you? Is it through a website at Holy Name? Is it through a Bergen County website? What?
Yeah, so Holy Name has a unique skill set in that we write a lot of our own software. So we wrote a specific application just for COVID vaccine administration. There's a website that you can go to. It's vaccine.holyname.org and register there. We currently have over 100,000 people waiting in that queue. We then push out digitally to you via text message and email an invitation to schedule when we know we have vaccines. So you go in and pick the date and time that is best suited for you. That same process goes seamlessly to the vaccinators who pull up your record, identify which arm, which lot number, which drug you're getting on that day, automatically schedule your second appointment, and then we push out a digital vaccine card. And for those who use iPhones, you can actually store that card in your Apple Wallet if you so desire.
Hey, Michael, you say you're vaccinating about 3,000 people per day, and you have the capacity to do up to 5,000 if you actually had the vaccine. But my question is, do you think there's actually 5,000 people that would show up every day? Are you seeing less vaccine hesitancy than you were just in the beginning of the year?
Yeah, so far, interesting fact, we have just started now to see a higher or a less response rate to invitations to book. We have filled every day. So we push out those invitations and people are responding. In the beginning, just a month ago, when we pushed out those invitations, people were signing up instantaneously. Now it's taking a little longer. Some of it's seniors, either their children or someone else signed them up. They're not being quite as responsive. So we find we have to push out more invitations to actually fill the opening slots. But we're still pushing most predominantly seniors. So as the age criteria lowers, we expect the response rate to go back up through the roof.
Michael, as you've shared with us right now, the vaccine distribution plan has been complicated, to say the least. Why don't you think the private sector has stepped up here? We have seen companies like Honeywell in North Carolina, Nike in Oregon, try to assist their home states with their vaccine plan. But I would expect more companies to do the same. Why don't you think they have?
Well, first off, so unless you're a real healthcare committed organization like Holy Name, there's no margin in this. And so that becomes a challenge. The other is people underestimate the complexity of this vaccine. These are very, very fragile drugs, especially the mRNA. So the Pfizer and the Moderna, deep, deep freeze, maintaining, transporting, preparing these vaccines. And they come in vials. Pfizer, you can get 5 to 6 out of a vial, Moderna, 10. J&J 5. And so you want to try to schedule in increments of five so we're not wasting drug. The minute you prep a vial, the vial has a very limited shelf life, 6 hours, at most 2 hours on Pfizer, on J&J. So you want to be able to move the drug very, very quickly. So the logistics of it are quite complex.
Michael, we may have to break to go to President Biden in the Rose Garden, but I know you had the illness last spring. You've been with us from last April, I believe, forward. Do you have any after effects? And in light of the fact that you did have the illness and therefore have the antibodies, have you been vaccinated or do you plan to be?
So it's a great question, Tyler. It is actually 1 year now that I was diagnosed with the virus. I have no long-term effects. I actually still have the antibodies, much less in a degree than I did early on, but I still test positive. I have not been vaccinated. It's not because I don't believe it. I actually do, and I will. The only reason I have not been vaccinated is because of the demand, and every day I'm dealing with people who are very frustrated. They want to get on that list. They want to be vaccinated. And I don't want anybody accusing me that I use my position and access to the drug to have myself vaccinated before they were. So as soon as the drug is in ready supply and I know people are getting it on a consistent basis, I will absolutely vaccinate myself.
Michael, great to see you again. Glad you're doing well. I have to say I used your hospital to get my knee fixed. It is better than ever, my friend. Michael Maron,
great.
Holy Name Hospital.